Hello again, everyone. This is Joe Hinches with Beyond the Chart. In this option trade review, we're going to take a look at a trade that we did on Walt Disney. And this was for my insider members, and it generated about a 30% profit in 8 trading days. Not huge, but it was still a very nice profit, so stay tuned. Okay, this is the information that I put out on the Trade Ideas page on the membership site, and so this is exactly how I lay it out for my insider members. On May 31st, I saw a potential re-entry sell setup for Walt Disney, and I said sell at 107.24. So here's what we're talking about, sell at 107.24. This was May 31st right here. You could see Disney was trending down, and then we got this pullback in here, and I was looking for a resumption of the trend to the downside. So I said, let's sell at 107.24. The option I'm looking at is a little out of the money, July 105 put. So July 105 is a strike price down here. And as the initial stop was going to be consecutive closes above the 10. Why? Because I didn't want to get whipsawed out of this. And so we, on the very first day, the entry day right here on June 1st, we got the entry, bought to open 8 of the July 105 puts. Now, this is, you know, we went out to the next month. I wanted to give us time. I didn't want the time premium to get sucked immediately if something started to go against us. So that was the play, and of course we got the entry right in here, and then what did it do? It ended up coming up and closing right on its high for the day. So it went against us a little bit, got a close above that 10-day moving average, but we never got the second close. You can see how it gapped up. It tried to challenge these highs right in here, and then just sold off dramatically, okay? So it started going our way. And then, so this was the entry day, and then a second day, a third day, and on the fourth day, the initial target that I had laid out at $104.66, that initial target was hit, and we just barely got there. The low was actually 104.61, but we hit the target, able to exit half the position at 255. Now, in 2020 hindsight on this trade idea, which was a 30% profit, I would have loved to have exited here. Why? Because this was up 73% actually. But you never know what you're going to get. You don't know what you're going to get on the second half. So the way I laid it out is I said, on this second half, let's do a stop on any close higher than the high 2 days ago. All right. Now, sometimes you could say the 2-day high or the high 2 days ago, one way is going to work out better one time and the other way is going to work out better another time. There is no guarantee on anything, but we had a stopped set up. So what happened? So here's the day where we got out on half. It came up the next day, a little pause. Came back down, dramatic close here below the prior day, the low here of the first half exit. And then we popped back up inside that Keltner channel. And then here was the exit day on for the second half on June 12th, sold the close for at 126 for $43.50 profit per contract, or 29.6% profit on the trade, so about 30%. So what could we have done better on this, okay? Given that, you know, other than trying to grab all of it on the first target hit, which, you could say, well, yeah, 20, but, you know, then you're locking yourself into whatever you get with that first target. And, you know, I like to see if I can ride this and make a little more. And I think what I would have done better is we got this close down here below the Keltner channel. Then we got the close back inside the Keltner channel. What I've found is that a lot of times after you get that close outside and you close back in, when you get a break of the high of that day, that's a nice time to exit. Now, there's no guarantees on anything, like back in here. You got significantly below the Keltner channels. You rode down, closed back inside. You exit at the high, and it chopped a little bit, but it kept pulling back, and then you could have gotten back in again like we did right here. So with this particular exit, I didn't exit till up here near the close at 107.04. It gave way too much back. Now, here's the other thing that you could have done better on this. Could have had a stop that said, and should have had a stop that said, I will not go below my entry point of 147. Again, got a little too greedy on here, thinking we'd ride some big move to the downside, and Disney started to chop and didn't have a big move. But should have had the stop at 147. Worst case, should have not taken a loss on the second half of the position. That's what hurt the profit in here. If I would have had the stop at 147, this would have been a little bit better at about 37% profit on the trade. All right, so that's a quick summary of that trade idea. I hope you found that helpful. If you like the video, hit the like button. And if you're not watching this on my website, head on over to the website, check that out. So remember, keep it simple, follow your plan, and trade without fear. Talk to you on the next video.